tattooing for 8 years, and I hail from a family that also has a famous tattoo. It's my brother. My brother and my sister-in-law both tattoo, so it's kind of a family thing at this point. As a profession, my favorite and my least favorite parts of it are probably very similar. It's like I love the social interaction. I love the never-ending sense of change and evolution. I love the fact that it is an all-consuming thing if you're gonna do it well. You're like circus people, you know? It's like all of a sudden your entire life revolves around this thing that you're doing, and it's not a vocation anymore, it's who you are. It establishes your identity. And those are things that are wonderful and incredibly energizing and fulfilling. But at the same time, it's like, yeah, you can imagine they're emotionally draining. You go home and you've been, you know, interacting with people on a very intimate level all day long, and you've been, you know, involved in this intense creative process. And you go home and you're just wrung out, and your friends are like, hey, let's go out. You know, you're just like, I just want to go home. Leave me alone. So yeah, there's the things you love and the things you hate are pretty similar sometimes. I like to try to approach all different things that are obviously suggested to me, but I really love doing pinups. It's kind of what I'm known for, a lot of figurative stuff. In fact, I've taught pinup drawing and tattooing workshops at tattoo conventions, and I'd love, this is hopefully something that'll happen in the next couple of years, but I'd love to put out a book on, you know, kind of reference photos, the evolution of how to kind of modify them in a direction that's more tattooable, great approaches for drapery, light, stuff like that. When a figure is clothed, their wardrobe's going to hang off them based on stress points. And a lot of people don't understand that, and there'll just be some sort of random, you know, wrinkling happening. And sometimes it's counterproductive to the flow of the piece, you know. So I'd like to try to, you know, help people understand a little bit more about dynamic flow, foreshortening, proportion, hair, all kinds of stuff. It all kind of works together to create a really good composition. And once people understand the fundamentals of why the composition works, that's a lot easier for them to take it in their own personal direction. Well, we were the family that always got the new box of 64 Crayolas every Christmas, so we've always been drawing. From there, I kind of took it into more of a personal direction with portraiture. When I was a teenager, I used to make a little extra money doing portrait commissions, mostly, you know, black and white graphite stuff. And it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. And then I kind of shelved it. My brother realized that I was really struggling with the, you know, typical litany of dead-end day jobs and suggested that I try tattooing. He and I both came from a very creative background, so it was a natural thing to try, and it really worked out.